conversation came up because you asked me a question about a song.
Yeah, yeah. I was listening. You know what? I was listening to Faster Pussycat.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Bathroom wall.
Write your number on the bathroom wall.
So do you remember the question that you asked me, though? Do you remember why it was that you called?
Yeah, I stopped the song, and I'm like, bro, let me ask you a question.
Well, wait. Before you say that, he calls, and he goes, bro, we got to talk about it. We need to talk.
And you're like, oh, shit.
And it's something, I don't know if you want to answer it now and get into it or if you want to think about it, which by then I'm friends with him long enough. I'm like, here comes some mundane bullshit funny thing because I know he's not serious. And say what the question was as soon as you're done choking on Mother Earth.
It's a natural expectorant.
I can tell.
Expectorant.
It's Earth's expectorant. All right. Okay,
so you call me.
Yeah, and I say, hey, man, why, if he wants this girl's phone number, he's obviously a rock star, he wants a girl's number, and then he's obviously in the same vicinity as her, why would he need her to write the number on the bathroom wall and go get it from there? Why wouldn't he just go up to her and go, hey, let me get your number?
That's a very good question.
Yeah. So I had the answer to it. I said, well, that's not what he says. What he says is, he's got your number off the bathroom wall.
Oh,
and it's about time I made the call. So I'm like, it makes sense like that.
And I looked at, I really, really evaluated it. And I was like, you know what? That's probably right. That is the perspective.
Oh, no. He went back. You went back and checked.
I checked the lyrics. I was freaking out.
That's valid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so now, you know, I owe Faster Pussycat an apology.
You've been singing their lyrics wrong for
40
years.
Well, because when they came out, Jane's Addiction was out. It was like 1985 and 1986. They ran fucking Sunset Boulevard. And their singer, Tammy, had a club called The Cat House with Ricky Rackman. It was one of the best places to go. Fun, drinks, you know, loose morals, 90s, 80s kind of metal scene. And Faster Pussycat was like one of those bands that when they came out, all of our bands were just like, ugh, this is terrible. This is a fucking terrible. Basic, blah, blah, rock and roll. And whatever. But they were a massive movement, you know? And then I always wrote it off as just like, oh, that's just, you know, that's the cute little band that does their thing. And then I listened back like the other day, and that's why I called Todd. And I was just like, here's what's so magical about recordings like that. Is like now in hindsight, I'm hearing youthful abandonment, youthful abandon and excitement and enthusiasm and a gang of dudes that we're going to look like this and they really mean it and their whole fucking lives are around it.
Mm-hmm.
It's really, you know, it's like those guys really did well, man. Cause good for them.
Did you know them?
Oh, yeah.
You're the buddies? Yeah.
I mean,
oh, yeah, in the same circles.
Same circles. Right. Yeah, of course. It was like the club scene, LA club scene back in the 80s, which was a lot of really great bands coming up. What do we got?
No, I was going to say, Dan was telling us earlier that we started into a conversation about how that's a common thing, that most people have a song that they know from their youth or their childhood or whatever, where you thought the lyrics were one thing and it always evolves into another thing. And Dan, if you want to tell what yours was.
The George Michael song, Father Figure.
Uh-huh.
I sang it as a kid. I thought he said, I will be your father's finger. And I honestly thought it was like an admission of pedophilia when I was a kid. I'm like, that's so fucking gross.
Which brings
I will be your father's finger. Put your tiny hand in mine.
Get the hell out of here.
No, wait.
Father's finger.
The tiny hand, he says?
Now,
really crazy.
Yeah.
I think that what you think it is says so much about your personality.
I don't know about that.
It does. Now, Dave,
it reveals more about you than anything else.
Right. Now, what's yours?
Because sometimes you hear what you want to hear, Dave.
You guys never let me finish. That's my friend said that, not me.
I think your friend hears what he wants to hear.
Now, you have
Dave
one.
Navarro
was mine.
You have one from the film Grease
that
we've been
Grease.
Talking about for years.
Homogenalities belong to yesterday.
So you think he used to think that word was homogenality.
Oh, yeah, that classic word.
Which it's actually conventionality. And, And
it's mine's better.
Yeah, but what
think about it.
But
originality. That sounds so
Why
much
would
better.
You think that that's what it is? It's not even a real word. That's what
it sounded like.
I had a similar thing with the theme song to Full House.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait. Really? Which one is a whatever happened to predictability?
I don't know. The milkman, the paperboy.
Yeah. Everywhere you look.
With weird 30s.
I thought the word predictive, whatever happened to the dip to did
right.
I didn't know predictability. Whatever happened to the dip to
fucking words. Like the dick to did
We all just start scatting.